Hello and welcome to Coinpedia Academy. In this video, we are going to talk about NFT, the non-fungible tokens that recently took the digital world by storm. In fact, NFTs are being sold for millions of dollars. For example, Elon Musk's tweet of a song on NFT is on sale and the highest bid stands for $1.1 million. Also, a digital artist Beeple's artwork was sold for an eye-popping price of $69 million and a single NFT card of Cristiano Ronaldo, Portuguese soccer superstar, was sold for $2,89,920. But what are these NFT tokens? How does this work and who can create this? A NFT is a non-fungible token existing on a blockchain. A token is a sign of ownership of an asset. For example, as concert ticket holder is the sign of ownership of a seat for the concert, in the same way holding token is sign of ownership of an asset. As token is stored on the blockchain and blockchain being transparent, anyone can see who holds which token. To make it much simpler, NFT can be referred to as digital representation of a unique asset that cannot be swapped or traded for any other asset. But hold on, before we head further, let's understand the major difference between fungible and non-fungible. Fungible refers to anything that is easily exchangeable like dollar, gold, or even cryptocurrencies. But a non-fungible token is a unique token that isn't exchangeable with any other like a painting, house, or a ticket to an event. But the most common example of NFTs are artwork. As I mentioned earlier about NFT artworks that are being bid for millions, we can say that artworks have been selling on blockchain for millions of dollars today. Artworks are not the only thing exchanged in these marketplaces. More and more demand in the NFT space is coming from sports as well. In fact, fans of basketball have already spent $230 million trading NBA Top Shot cards, a latest crypto collectible craze in which the most iconic moments in NBA history are turned into non-fungible tokens. NFTs are unique as NFT uses blockchain to identify its authenticity. Before we dig further into how NFTs work, let's see how to create an NFT. Blockchain allows standardization and creation of NFTs, which ensures all aspects of NFTs like ownership, transfer, access, and controls are combined on one common decentralized system, and the most common at the moment is Ethereum network. So there are three standardization processes that will take NFTs on Ethereum platform. They are ERC-721, ERC-998, and ERC-1155. ERC stand for Ethereum Request for Comments. As there is no one person or entity who decides what new features to add or what changes to make, ERC is a process that was created for people to contribute information about Ethereum or introduce new feature to the Ethereum network. So the numbers such as 721998 or 1155 represents the unique IDs of those particular proposals made. This brings us to the next key feature, that is interoperability. With interoperability, blockchain allows NFTs to be moved into multiple ecosystems. So when anyone is creating NFTs, it's immediately visible and tradable on all NFT marketplaces. With free trading on an open marketplace, takes us to the next key property, that is tradability. With this feature, now for the first time ever, users across the world can create and launch NFTs that will immediately place marketplaces on the entire ecosystem. Marketplaces are a platform that helps you to tokenize the collectibles, and these marketplaces allow people to buy, sell, trade, bid, or even auction NFT for cryptocurrencies. So how does these NFTs work exactly? As mentioned earlier, NFTs are digital certificates, so they can be bought or sold just like any other valuable item. When you buy an NFT, you receive a certificate secured with blockchain technology, and that makes you the owner of that particular digital asset. Are you wondering if Bitcoin and NFTs are similar? Not exactly. Though NFTs and blockchain fall under cryptocurrencies, what makes NFTs different is that it cannot be used directly as a medium for commercial transaction. Bitcoin is fungible, which means it can be traded or exchanged for one another. But two NFTs are never identical. It can be said that NFTs are unique collectible cards which can be owned only by one person. Now, if you want to buy or sell NFTs, the first thing you need to do is install MetaMask, a digital wallet for Ethereum. Once the MetaMask is installed, you can buy Ethereum. Now, when you visit any website that allows you to buy or sell NFTs, you can use the purchased Ethereum to buy an NFT. By now, I'm sure you must have understood what NFTs are, the key feature that blockchain allows for NFTs, and how does this work. So let's talk about how NFTs could be used in the future across multiple industries. We are already seeing art, collectibles, and gaming in the virtual world. But the gaming industry will be drastically affected as NFTs will make gaming more tangible and rewarding. Also, filmmakers or musicians can register their work on blockchain in the form of an NFT to protect their work against copyright, which will remove the need for intermediaries like agents or managers. To conclude with, we can say that NFTs will surely introduce new people to crypto space and take the adoption of blockchain technology to the next level.